students, I am Satish Kumar Sinha, physics teacher from Gyan Niketan Girls School. Today we are going to discuss the first chapter, Physics, Heat, Part 2. We have learned in last class that heat flows from a hotter object to a colder object until both objects reach the same temperature. How does this transfer of heat energy take place? The transfer of heat energy can take place in three different ways. That is, there are three modes of transfer of heat. First one is conduction, second is convection, third is radiation. First, we define the term conduction. Conduction is the process of transfer of heat from hotter part of the material to the colder part without actual movement of the molecules or particles. And the transfer of heat by the process of conduction only takes place in solids. It cannot occur in liquids and gases. Now, what are the two conditions for the conduction of heat? So there are two conditions for the conduction of heat. First one is both the objects should be placed in contact. Means the two bodies or two objects should be in contact with each other. Second condition for the conduction of heat is the two bodies should have different temperature, because heat always flows from one body to the other body or one part to the other part of the body if there is a temperature difference. If the temperature of both the ends of the conductors are same, then transfer of heat will be stopped. So what are the two conditions for the conduction of heat? First one is the two objects should be in contact with each other, and second is the two bodies should have different temperatures. Now, good conductors, or simply conductors. How do you define the term conductors? Materials that allow heat to pass through them easily. That types of materials that allow heat to pass through them easily are called good conductors of heat. What are the examples? All the metals like copper, gold, silver, zinc, aluminium, mercury are the good conductors of heat. Good conductor means they carry the heat from one part to the other part of the body. Here we give one example. How can heat will be transferred from one part to the other part of the body? So here we give one example. See that here one candle is there, and here one spoon is there. So here how can conduction will be takes place, all of you see here. This is the candle and this is the flame of the candle, and here we take one spoon. If you place the one end of the spoon in contact with the flame of the candle, after 2 minutes or 3 minutes, we will observe that it is difficult to hold this spoon. Why? Because heat will be transferred from the hotter part to the colder part. Hotter part to the colder part without actual movement of the molecules or particles. Gradually it will be transferred from one part to the other part. So this is an example of conduction, that heat is transferred from one part to the other part due to the without actual movement of the particles. So this is the one activities. Now next is the what is poor conductor of heat. Poor conductor, sometimes also it is called insulators. Materials that do not allow heat to pass through them easily are called insulators or poor conductors of heat. Some examples of poor conductors or insulators are wood, paper, leather, cotton, cloths, asbestos, etc. So these are the two types of, one is the conductors, that is good conductors of heat, another is the poor conductor of heat, that is insulator. Now, what is convection? Convection is the mode of transfer of heat from the hotter part of the liquid to its colder part by the actual movement of molecules. In this process, that is the mode of transfer of heat in convection, the particle actually move from one part to the other part of the body. Suppose if you have to heat the water, then first the molecules of water in contact with the container gets heat, and after getting heat, it becomes lighter and moves in the upward direction. Then the colder part, where the molecules are situated or particles are situated, the molecules from the surroundings come to take its place. Again, it takes heat and it becomes lighter and moves in the upward direction. And this process is continuous till the temperature of water becomes same. So due to convection process, the heat is transferred from hotter part of the liquid to its colder part by the actual movement of molecules. Convection cannot take place in solids because the particles in solids are fixed at a place and hence cannot move freely. Convection only takes place in liquid and gases. Now, students, some home assignments are there. First question is, define temperature. Second is, what is a thermometer? Third, why is mercury used in thermometers? Fourth, what are conductors? Give two examples. Thank you.